Okay, hi everyone, welcome back to another video. Today's video, I am in front of the camera. Sorry for the bad lighting. It is raining outside, it's cloudy, so the lighting is not going to be great. I am saving up for a ring light, so hopefully when I get that, I can start doing better videos. But today, I wanted to be in front of the camera and show you guys what I have to present to you guys today. Today's list is a countdown list, and it is on my top 17 favorite Padme Amidala items. If you're new to my channel and don't know, but it is kind of obvious, Padme Amidala has always been my favorite Star Wars character, and I felt like doing this list today, so why not? We're gonna start. Now, the reason I picked 17 is because I could not pick 10. I tried to and failed at it. So that's why. I, of course, love all my Padme items. They're all amazing, but I just picked 17 to show you. And this list could change from time to time because I am saving up for some Padme more high-end collectible stuff. The main one is the Padme versus Nexu Sideshow statue I'm saving up for. I really, really want that. So that could be the number one spot on my list once I get that. Who knows? I have to wait and see how I like it. And but I'm saving up for it right now. So we're going to start. Like I said, my list can change from time to time. My list always change. My favorite list always change anyways. And so let's get started. Number 17 is a Happy Meal toy from Taco Bell. I think this is Taco Bell. Back in 1999, when Episode 1 came out, Phantom Menace, they did three promotional fast food places. They did KFC, Taco Bell, and Pizza Hut, where they had different toys at. And I think this one is Taco Bell. I could be wrong, but it's called Queen's Hidden Identity. And sorry for the bad lighting again. But you get two Queen Amidala figures. Technically, this is Sabe, her decoy. But Natalie Portman did wear this outfit in some promotional pictures, so that's probably why they did it. And then you get a Padme Nabari figure. And what you do is you can open up Queen Amidala, and you can place the Padme Handmaiden inside Queen Amidala, and it's supposed to reveal that Queen Amidala is Padme. You also can do the same thing to Sabe, or the decoy, or Queen Amidala, whatever you want to call her. This was back at the time when Queen Amidala and Padme was supposed to be two different characters. Like Palpatine and Darth Sidious were supposed to be two different characters. But we all know by now that Queen Amidala is Padme, because in Episode 1, she's introduced as the Handmaiden, and then later it's said that Padme is Queen Amidala. So, and for little Happy Meal toys, these are pretty nicely detailed. I think the face sculpt on the Padme figure is pretty good for a Happy Meal toy. Focus is horrible, I know. But I don't want to spend too much time on one item, so that is number 17. Here's the box if you wanted to see. It's called Queen Amidala Hidden Identity. So number 16 is the Applause 1999 vinyl figure of Queen Amidala, or Padme, in her battle dress. And this is just a PVC figure of Padme. For 1999, I think the face sculpt is pretty good. The hair is nicely sculpted. The boots are nicely sculpted, and the only articulation it has is in her head. But the other is like statues, so, but it is plastic, and the details are nice on it. Number 15, now some things I included together because they are the same thing. So like for this example, number 15 are the two Zoom Zooms, the two Amidala Zoom Zooms. One is from Episode 1 when she's in her Queen Zeta Evasion outfit, and then the other one is from Episode 2 when she is in her Joy Factory Arena outfit. And these are adorable. They're plush. I got this one off eBay, then a YouTuber friend gave this one to me a while ago, and they're cute, as I said, and obviously once I saw that they made these, I had to have them, so. Then number, 14 is, now I have some figures on this list, but I also got down the carded figures, because when it comes to Hasbro Padme figures, I get two of, because I like to collect, both loose and carded, and that is the Hasbro 6-inch Black Series Padme figure, and I also do have her carded as well, but here she is carded. Hopefully you can see that okay. I know the lighting, again, is horrible, but, this is a nice figure. I was really excited that Padme was in the 6-inch line. Although I would prefer a different outfit. That's just me, though. She comes with a pistol. She also comes with a droid blaster. But she doesn't use that until her shirt is ripped. So I don't display her with that. I know a lot of people do. And you can also take off the cape if you wanted to have her before she gets her ripped. Shirt ripped, but I like to leave her this way because there's another reason why I like to leave her that way. So, that is number 14. This is a good figure, although on my face sculpt, it is a little wonky. Sorry if you can hear the dog, he's right next to me. I'm sorry, buddy. He's whining, but my face sculpt is a little wonky on mine, unfortunately, but I still think this is a good figure. Now, number 13 is a doll. I have some dolls on this list. I do have all the dolls except one toner doll. And it's the beautiful braids Padme Berry. And her hair is really long because you can do her hair. But for these dolls, I think they came out in 1999. I think they did a really good job with the face sculpt. I think they did try to, you know, sculpt Natalie Portman in there. But I love the hair. It's so soft. I try not to play with it too much. She is in her Tatooine outfit when she tends to be the handmaiden. And then she comes with this bun, which is a stiff, which I do like. And yeah, there's not too much to say about that. But that is number 14. Like I said, I don't want to spend too much time on each item. Number 12 is, I'm not going to take this out of the box because I actually did have this. Once out of the box and it broke, so I had to get a new one, is the Episode 1 Queen Amidala clock. And it's in her Senate outfit, and sorry for the glare, but, I leave this in the box just because, I don't want to break it. So this is in her Senate outfit, and, this is the clock, and it's, just a clock. You can put batteries in it and it will tell time. And it's the Queen Amidala is a statue. So, but there's the back if you want to pause and read. Side and the other side, I got this off eBay. A lot of people wonder where I get my stuff, and it's mostly eBay. So, number 12 is Black Series 3-inch. Padme Amidala figure, and I also do have her loose right here, and she was the first in line of, obviously she's in her arena outfit, that's the most popular outfit, clearly in episode 2, that Hasbro thinks, because that's all they do their stuff of. I wish they would do new outfits, but I do have her carded as well. Now, originally, the Black Series was going to be a part of this wave, the Joy Factory wave, but it was cancelled, so only, like, UK, I think, got this wave, and, a long time ago, a friend was able to help me get this carded, because I needed it for my carded Padme collection. Unfortunately, it's a little bent, and that's why she's in this, but this was the original, before the Black Series. But then they changed it to the Black Series, and that's where this figure comes from. You know, this is what you could find in stores in the US, but there's the back. I had to put her in a Revenge of the Sith clamshell, just because I didn't want her to get damaged, but it's a pretty nice figure. I really like it. It's probably one of my favorite Padme figures. I know that you can't really see it all that well, but I think the face sculpt for a 3-inch Padme figure is really nicely done. And you can see the neck few scratches, and she has her blaster. This is when I do display her with the blaster, is when she has her ripped shirt and arm, and she does come with the pistol as well. So there is number 12. Number 11 is, now I have switched it up because that was actually higher on my list, but this I wanted to be higher on my list, and it's the Unleashed Padme Amidala, again in the arena outfit, and this came in the Unleashed series. Sorry, my foot is falling asleep, because I'm sitting on the floor, and this is a pretty good one, too. She comes with all this chain you can wrap around her, and she can, obviously come off her base, but there's no point of taking her off her base just because, she can't stand without her base because she has that peg. But she goes back on it, and it's a pillar from the arena battle, and she has some dust on her to look like she's dirty. She has the arena scratches, and I think the face sculpt is another good one. Is it my favorite one? Probably not, but it's still good for the time, early 2000s. So that is number 11. Number 10 is, now, like I said, I included some things 2 and 1. Number 10 are the Amidala ornaments. I do have another one it's actually right here. I'll show you. I do have this one in the box. I didn't include it because it's just like the theater version, which I'm about to show you, but less detailed. So I did include the ornaments of Queen Amidala in her theater version outfit. And this came out in 1999 as well. So this is a very beautiful ornament. I display them on my Padme shelf. Obviously, I don't store them away for Christmas, but sometimes I will put them out during Christmas time out in the living room, or not on the tree because I don't want them to break. But then in 2003, they did come out with a Padme one from episode 2, of course, in her arena outfit. And it's just another arena Padme, but she does have the scratches right there. She's holding her blaster. And these were Hallmark ornaments. And, these are pretty cool as well. So I'm really glad to own both of these. Like I said, I do have this one, but it's just the theater version, but this is more of a cheaper one. So that's why I didn't include it on the list. Now, number 9 is the Funko Pops. I, again, included both of them because there are 2 Amidala Funko Pops. Oops, this is Bradley. If you look, say hi, Bradley. Say hi. He wants attention right now. But this is the first... this is the first Amidala Funko Pop, and it's Queen Amidala in her theater vision gown. And this one is very special to me for a couple reasons. It's not just it's Padme, but my mom, who is no longer with us, gave her to me for 2014 in Christmas. So I was really glad and excited to have this. Now this pop is retired, so you can't get her anymore unless you want to pay a high price, like hundreds of dollars. Which I'm really glad I do have this pop, because I would be so sad if I didn't, and I would probably end up paying high prices just to get her. But there's the back of the pops in the wave. Just a really beautiful pop. This is actually my favorite Funko Pop in my Funko Pop collection. And then the next one is another Arena Padme item, which are quite a few Arena Padme items in this list, because it's her most popular outfit besides the theater vision gown. But this one was a Funko Springs Convention exclusive, and I think you still can get her pretty cheap. I'm not sure how much she goes for now, because I have her, so I don't look her up. I did want another one once upon a time to open, but She's not sold in stores anymore. I believe this was a GameStop exclusive as well, shared exclusive. So, but there was supposed to be an episode 3 Padme Funko Pop in her Mustafar outfit announced, but then it got canceled right away. So, unfortunately, that did not happen. But there's the others you can get in the wave. And this is another one of my favorite Funko Pops. I think I like the Theater Vision down one a little bit better. just because, it's more special to me because my mom gave it to me. But then we have number 8 or 9. I'm gonna say 9. We have the Theater Vision Queen Amidala mini bust. And I actually had to replace this because mine broke. It fell off the shelf. So when I saw this on eBay, I jumped on it and, I didn't realize how, rare this was on eBay. It didn't, pop up on eBay much, but it was a little used, but it's fine to me. And the details on her is pretty good. And I got her for a really good price, $30. So I think that's a really good price for a bust. And it's just Queen Amidala in her theater outfit. And the details are really nicely done on it as well. And there's the bottom. Not sure what year this came out. Oh, it says right there, 2008. But it's really pretty as well. So, and then number 8, I'm just kind of going now, is the Padme Evolutions battle set, collector set. And I do have this card as well. And it comes with 3 Padme figures. It comes with the pre-Senate Queen Amidala, the Joy Factory Chase, which was later repacked onto a single card, which I do have, I just didn't get down, Padme, and then the Mother of Heroes Episode 3 Padme in her nightgown. Like I said, when it comes to Hasbro, I get Padme's loose and carded, so obviously I do have this carded, and it's a little easier to see carded, and it's such a beautiful box set, and I really love the picture right here of Queen Amidala. And Padme Amidala, the Padme Evolutions of Padme Amidala Legacy. And I know it's probably backwards, but you can pause and read if you want, if you can see that. But it's such a beautiful set, and I'm really glad to have it. And I'll just go through each figure one by one. But here's the pre-Senate Queen Amidala. The details on her is really nicely done. I love the dragging effect right there. And the long hair. She did have long hair in episode 1. A little too long. I don't remember it being that long, but it is pretty long. She has shoes under there. Then here, this one is... excuse me. And this one is just her in her Droid Factory Chase outfit. But, yep, so... I am saving up for a ring light, so they're not that expensive either. I just haven't got one yet, so. But here's the episode 3 Padme as well. See, her hair's not as long as episode 1. So, yes. And then we get into my 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 top 5 items. We were, I guess, on number 6. And the number 6 item is another bust, and it is the Joy Factory Chase Padme bust. And this one came out in 2002, and this is a nice one too. The face is nice. I really like the hair on it, though. I think the hair is sculpted nicely. And bust, as you probably can see, I have no arms or legs. They're just the body. And, but yeah, but this is a nice one as well. So there's the back of that as well. And then we get to number 4. And that is another Arena Padme item. And this is the SH Figuarts Padme figure. And the reason I display the Black Series Padme with her cloak on... sorry, he's whining. Is because I already have this one. And this one is the SH Figuarts one, which I did a review on it, so I'm not going to spend too much time on it. It's a pretty nice figure. The price, I would not pay the price it goes for now, but she's like $200+ on eBay, and I would love to get another one because unfortunately her arm broke. So, yep. And the dog is being a bug again. What? Stop. It's okay. But the only thing weird about this one is they give her the rip in the shirt, as you can see, but they did not give her blood or the scratches. But it's just another Rina Padme figure. But it's still a pretty nice one, and I do like that face sculpt a lot, and it looks a lot like Natalie Portman. I think it's better than the Black Series one, just because it's more high-end and more collectible. And then number three is my favorite Padme doll, and this one came in, it's part of the Queen Amidala, three dolls that came in the Senate, the post-Senate, and then the decoy. And then this one came with Qui-Gon Jinn, and it's in her battle outfit, and I really like this one. It comes with her bun is stiff and really nicely done, and the face sculpt's okay. I think they did a good job for what it is. It does resemble Natalie Portman to some extent, and then she's in her battle outfit, which is a nicely done on the doll, and she comes with her pistol, which I keep in her hand. So, and then I'm just gonna have to put this down. Number two is actually my favorite Queen Amidala action figure, and it is the OC Queen Amidala figure. Again, I do have this carded because I do get all the Padme's loose and carded again. This is the last time I'm gonna say that because this is the last figure, but here it is carded, and it's my favorite Queen Amidala figure, and such a beautiful figure. There's the back if you want to pause and read, and the other figures in the wave. And here's the figure right here. The only thing that's wrong with it is she does not have the white makeup. Stop it. Out. Sorry, the dog is whining. I should have closed the door. But the white makeup is missing. But other than that, this is a stunning figure and probably one of my favorite Padme items. But that could change in the future, and the cloak is beautiful, and I think they did a good job on the face sculpt. And she does come with the globe of peace, which just sits in her hand. If I can not drop it. It just sits in her hand. You get the idea anyway. As you can see, like that, I put some tack on it a long time ago to help it, but it dried, I think, so. But, like that, so. That is number two. And then number one is my most favorite Padme item right now. It's in the arena outfit again. It is in the arena outfit again, and is the Atactus Padme statue, and I got this year for my birthday, and I really love this statue. It is by Atactus. Again, it is in her arena outfit, but I think the face sculpt is really well done. I think it does resemble Natalie Portman really well. She comes with her blaster. She is in her arena outfit, and she does have the scratches too, and I do keep this on my Padme shelf. And there's the bottom. And like I said, I'm saving up for more high-end Padme collectibles like this. Just because I want more of the expensive stuff, I guess. But yeah, so that is number one. I just put that down gently. So let me know your thoughts. I know this was a long video. Do you have any Padme stuff? Do you collect Padme? What are your thoughts on Padme as a character? I personally always loved her. I think she's strong. She's badass. And I know a lot of people didn't like her in episode 3. But I loved her in all the movies. And Natalie Portman did an amazing job playing her. But yeah, let me know what you think of my list. And until next time, I will see you guys later. Check out my Instagram down below. And I will see you guys later. My Instagram is where I post like every day or every couple days, mostly every day when I have stuff to post. And I will see you guys later and have a great day. And please subscribe to my channel. And until the next video, hopefully it will be soon. I will see you guys later.